Hello again. In this screencast, I'm going to show you how to get started with building your first yFiles for HTML powered application. There are many other options and some of them are way more comfortable than this one. However, this time I'm going to use no external tool chain or third-party components to concentrate on the bare minimum that is required for a yFiles powered web app. If you want to use a more modern approach with tools like Webpack, Angular, CLI, TypeScript, etc., please take a look at the other videos and sample applications that come with the evaluation package. This video should allow you to truly understand the bare minimum requirements in order to get started. We're going to use the free Visual Studio Code IDE for development, and we'll be authoring our app in plain HTML5 with modern JavaScript code and nothing else but the evaluation package of yFiles for HTML. This means that the app will not run on legacy browsers like Internet Explorer, without a separate transpiler step that could be added any time later, but this also gets you great turnaround times and a very good development experience with the modern browser development tools. I'm going to use Chrome for this task here. So let's start. So first I'm going to create a new directory. I already downloaded and extracted the evaluation package over here. So let's create a new folder, call it graph app, and now I'm going to use Visual Studio Code. I'm going to open that folder and we'll start by adding an index.html page. So this is going to be just a simple HTML page. My first graph app, and what we need is a place on the web page to actually display our graph. So we're going to add a div, give it an ID, and also some space on the screen. So I'm going to add some style over here. Just for the graph component. We need to reserve space because it's unclear how what size the component should be. So let's give it 300 pixels width and height. And just so that we see something, let's give it some background, some nice light blue, and see how that looks like. Yep, that's simple, of course. So let's just get it. Okay, now we need to get the yFiles library sources in order to get some JavaScript to run. Let's go back to the evaluation package. I'm going to copy over the lib folder, get it into my graph app. And now I can load the yFiles related styles. So I'm going to link the CSS file that's in lib yFiles CSS. So far so good. And now to the actual code. There are several options on how to actually load the JavaScript files for yFiles for HTML. The most simple one that also works from the file system is AMD module loading. We could be using simple script tags too or ES6 imports, but the first option is rather tedious and comes with performance drawbacks, and the second one doesn't work from the file system. So we would actually have to set up a local dev web server, which I don't want to do in this video. For AMD loading, we have a simple implementation of an AMD loader available in the package that you can use directly. So let's get that too. It's in demos resources required.js. Just copy that over to file and load it. We're going to load it over here. That's required.js. And Now for the actual code. In order to load to JavaScript, we're going to use the require call and tell it that we require the library which is in libumd yFiles complete. So in lib there's both the ES6 modules and the UMD modules, and the UMD modules has many different modules. One of them is the complete module, which contains the complete library in one bundle. So, and once we load that, we will get the yFiles main namespace object. Just see if that works. So let's log out the yFiles version. So here we go. Let's go to the console. Yeah, and there's the version. It's 2.1. So we successfully loaded the library. That's fine. Now let's do something with it. So we're going to instantiate the graph component into the div that we allocated above to actually host our graph viewer and editor. So we're going to introduce new yFiles view graph component. Mind the spelling. And the first argument that we can use is a CSS selector that indicates where to actually instantiate the graph component. See if that worked. Ooh, what's that? One thing is still missing. We need to have the license in place and actually to start working with it. So let's go back to the evaluation version. And in the evaluation version, the license is in the resources folder. Let's just open this one and see. Yeah, here it is. Just copy that line with a license and just add it to your application. We don't need the log anymore. Reload, and yeah, this looks like a very basic graph component. Nothing in there yet, but it's working. That's great. So now to something actually useful. We're going to store the component in a variable. And now that's awesome. That's not awesome, that's actually awful. We don't have any code completion. That sucks. Even though code completion is optionally, actually, you're not going to become very efficient without code completion. So this is optional, but I'm going to show you how to enable code completion in Visual Studio Code anyway. So we're going to first create a typings directory. This is where we're going to store the code completion information. And need to get back to the evaluation version. There's this IDE support folder. There's a bunch of files in there that will help you. Since we're going to use Visual Studio Code and the UMD version of yFiles for HTML, this is the file we were looking for. So let's just drag it over here. And in order to tell Visual Studio Code that it should actually make use of the typings information, we need to now create another file in the root of the application, and that's jsconfig.js, and it's actually .json. JSON, and it's actually enough to initially have an empty file for that. So in order to, this is what Visual Studio Code will warn you. In order to actually enable the TypeScript language features, we should exclude the larger folders that we have in our source file system. So just press the button, configure excludes, and we got back to the config JSON, and now we need to exclude the lib folder, which we don't require the Visual Studio Code app to parse because it contains all of the modules. So once we've done that, There's one more thing we need to do. We should be refactoring the code so that the contents of this script pack actually come into a separate JavaScript file. So let's call it app.js. Copy over that code. And we can remove it over here from here. So we're going to have the script source and so app.js. And now in our app.js file, see if it still works. Yeah, that's fine. Let's see, what about code completion? Still nothing. What's the problem here? Problem is that we have this simple yFiles argument over here, which is just the callback of the require function. Visual Studio Code doesn't know that this is actually the yFiles namespace. So we need to give it a hint in order to enable actually the code completion. So there's this way of telling it that this type over here is actually of type yFiles namespace, which is defined in the DTS file, in the tidings file over here. And now that we have that defined, ta-da, we get code completion. So once I write some code here, suddenly there's all the methods that are available and the properties available on the graph component class, and I get the documentation over here. So now this makes it a lot easier to actually start coding. So let's actually create some elements in the graph. So we have the graph control, it hosts the graph model. So let's just, and there's factory methods for all kinds of things graph related. So let's create a node, const n1, it's one node over here. And let's create another node, and we have the option to specify location size. Put it to the left, not so far maybe. So, and see if that works. No, there's still a problem. So obviously I made a mistake, but it's unclear what was the problem. So let's take a look at the console. There's some exception below. Yeah, that's a stupid mistake, of course. I redefined the variable, but I could also have made a mistake in the code like this. For example, if I want to create an edge and I use the create edge method, and I could be using n1 and n2, this would work. But if, for example, I had the wrong type or another type over here, this is what would happen. I would get some weird long stack trace that tells me that I cannot create an edge from a port that doesn't belong to this graph. That's misleading, actually, in this case. And this is because we're using the production version of yFiles for HTML, which only contains very few tests at runtime to improve the runtime performance. If we want to get clear error messages telling us exactly what went wrong, this is what we can do instead. So we are going to copy one more file over here. This is the yFiles type info JavaScript file. We're going to put it into, let's put it into lib. And over here, so I don't need to open that. And make sure that it's loaded first. So let's just add another script source and tell it to load yFiles type info.js first. Now let's see what happens. The next time that we reload, we still get an error, but this time it says argument error in create edge, wrong type for a second parameter target. We expected type inode, but we got a string. And the real signature is actually create edge, and we need to pass it a source node and a target node, and then optionally a style and the tag. So this Now, knowing this, of course, we can fix the problem. And let's make it correct and see what happens. Yeah, finally, we have graph and it's working and no exceptions anymore on the console. Cool. So what next? It looks a bit dull and there's nothing you can actually do to interact with the graph, so let's change that. So first we're going to iterate over all the nodes in the graph. So we're also interested in the index. So notice that code completion is working fine, so we would like to add some labels for the node, and let's just use the index as a string label text on the node, see what happens. Yeah, we got the label, and now change the styling. Maybe we can set the style of the node to a new, what do you have? Shape node style over here, for example. And let's configure that style. So give it a fill of maybe some HSL color, like this. We make it dependent on the index. Oops, like this. So that should be the fill. And also we make the stroke a thin white stroke around, and we change the shape to ellipse. Okay, I'm missing some comma over here. So now that's nicer. Cool. So what next? I would like to interact with my graph. So let's assign an input mode to my graph component. We have several input modes available, and the most important ones probably being graph viewer input mode and graph editor input mode. If you just want to edit your, if you just want to view your graphs, then this is probably the one that you should go for. And the editor input mode also enables you, editing the graph. So let's see how that works. Reload. This is my graph. Now I can select it, change the size of the node, add new nodes to the graph, create edges, and so on. So, nice. But the graph is still ugly, so one final thing to add to the graph would be an automatic layout. So there's a convenience method available on graph control, which is called morph layout, and I need to specify a layout, and we are going to use yFiles, the hierarchic layout over here, and some morph duration, maybe for 2 seconds, and see if that works. No, that's a hierarchic layout. Cool. Nice. So this was just a very short introduction on how to get started with yFiles for HTML without using any third-party software or tooling. This, of course, doesn't mean that you can't use the library with all the modern, new and shiny JavaScript and TypeScript tooling, but it's good to know that you can do without, actually. So go ahead and give it a try yourself. Thank you.